Hello, I'm Kiro Wakan, also known as Corey's Cornics, and welcome to Classy Movie Rambles, where I talk about old movies that I find in my closet while cleaning. This week's movie is Toy Story 2, and it's about 1 hour and 28 minutes long. It starts with Buzz flying down on a planet, fighting some robotic enemies, and eventually the enemy's boss, Zurg himself, and it turns out that it's just a video game. And then Woody, the main cowboy, I guess, the cowboy toy, is upset about losing his hat, and eventually he finds it. And then the family dog, owned by Andy or Mom, I guess, kind of enters the room and attacks him, but it turns out it's friendly. And then Andy enters the room as well. He wants to play a bit with his toys before he leaves for cowboy camp. And then he rips Woody's arms by mistake, and he has to leave the toy behind and go to cowboy camp without him. So Andy, or not Andy, but Woody has a nightmare about the whole ordeal. And later there's a yard sale. So Woody goes down to the yard sale to basically save one of the toys from being sold. He managed to do so, but gets stolen by this guy called Al and gets taken away. And the others try to figure out who took Woody. So they figure out this guy called Al, and he's dressed in like a chicken suit, and he's on this work for this toy company. So Buzz and the others decide to go rescue him while Woody befriends some other toys at Al's place, and basically they're part of like a whole collection called the Woody's Roundup. So a bit later on, Woody loses his arm completely, gets completely ripped and torn, and Al, the thief, puts it in his pocket, so Woody kind of has to take it from him while he's sleeping. But someone turns on the TV when he's trying to grab the hand, and Woody actually blames Jesse, this cowboy doll, for it, but it isn't really her, it's someone else. And meanwhile, this is happening, the other toys, you know, they arrive at the toy store where they figure out that Al actually works as like a part-time job or something. And Buzz runs into this other Buzz Lightyear toy, and he sees this MacGuffin belt, I guess, and wants it for his own, but the other Buzz Lightyear is not having it. There's actually a whole aisle of Buzz Lightyear toys. So the real Buzz gets encased in a box, and the other one gets mixed up with the other toys, so they don't really know that it's their old Buzz is someone else's. So meanwhile this is happening, Jessie the cowboy doll tells her a sad story about how she was lost, because she understands the connection that Andy has with Woody. So Jessie basically got neglected and found, and then she was donated, because, you know, kids grow up into adults and they don't play with toys when they're adults. So that's all that. So the other toys arrive at the Al's office. I think they go into like a bag and they end up at the office or something like that. But it turns out that the main bad guy is actually the one who turned on the TV was this girl called Stinky Pete. And his whole ordeal is that he is not complete unless the whole Roundup set is complete, because he was totally neglected and doesn't want that to happen. And the whole collector says they're supposed to go to Japan to this museum, but Woody kind of want to leave with all of the crew and everything just to be with Andy, and the other toys think it's a good idea, but Stinky Pete is not having it. So that's a thing. And I totally forgot, but during the process there was this guy that repaired Woody's arm, so it's now hunky-dory. And meanwhile the other kids were at the toy store as well. I forgot about that too. It was this enemy toy to Buzz Lightyear that followed them called Zurg. So now it's after them. So in this elevator shaft there's this funny scene that is ripped out of Star Wars, where the new Buzz Lightyear toy fights the Zurg boss, and it's like right out of Star Wars, as I said, like, you killed my father, and then no, I am your father. And that whole screaming that Luke does in the movie, he screams no word for word and everything. And it's a funny thing about this movie, because it has a lot of Star Wars sound effect from lasers and stuff as well. So this was before Pixar was ever part of Disney, mind you, as well. So the other toys goes after Al, but he's on his way to the airport, and they take a pizza delivery truck or like car, and they kind of, since they're toys, they cannot really reach up for the wheel, and now the real Buzz is with them helping them drive, and it's all over a mess. But they manage to arrive at the airport, and there's this gag about Al, you know, be careful with this case, because it's more, these toys in this case or whatever is more than you make in a year or whatever. They put it down this conveyor belt. And the whole ordeal is that they managed to stop Stinky Pete with these flash-like light bulbs thing you have for camera, like flashes. And they put Pete into a box of a little girl-like bag. with Barbies, so he got the bad outcome of this. And the Woody, Bullseye, and Buzz goes to save Jesse on this plane. I think Woody's actually up on a plane, and he saves Jesse, and they swing down beneath the wheels, just as about to take off, and they kind of get on Bullseye, and it's everything's good. They go back to Andy's house, and it ends on a happy note. And after this funny scene, where they actually have a gag reel of all the jokes and everything that you just put in for a comedical effect, but that's pretty much the end of the movie. So what do I think about Toy Story 2? It's a good movie, but I think I prefer the third one more. I think I reviewed it for this channel, maybe, I don't remember. It was a long time ago anyway. So it's a good movie. It's come a long way since the first movie, and technology is it's like the thing with animation, I guess, that it evolves and the technology gets better and you get better shaders. You can have more polygons and render more stuff. So, I mean, this is a good movie. I think, I don't think I can recommend it, but it's a good movie. I think it's good. So anyway, thanks for listening and or watching, and take care.